So we started off with a 60-pound easy bar, 60-pound straight bar bicep curls for dirty 30s. Dirty 30s are basically just three sets. Well, I do three sets, you can do as many as you want, but do one set of 30 reps, 10 reps bar, 10 reps mid, and then 10 reps close. All those are grips. And then we come over here. I personally lack like triceps, so I'm gonna hit my triceps and then I'm gonna move on to biceps. And then to end off the day, I'm gonna hit forearms. So that's the plan for today. Here goes nothing. So that's my second set of 50 pounds. 60 pounds for two sets, eight reps each. And then now I'm gonna hit 85 pounds again. Range for reps is up to you, but for me personally, I would like to go anywhere from 5 to 8. So minimum 5 reps on this, I wanna get, I'd be happy. If not, hopefully I get 10. Only got for 4 reps, but would have had more reps. I didn't fuck up my mic. So basically, I'm just gonna hit this for probably 2 more sets, rep it out for 8 to 5 reps. After that, I'll be satisfied with that, and then we'll go on to a few other attachments. If not, if we don't go to a few other attachments, we'll just go do different things that target different areas of the tricep. But I also gotta hit reverse grip on this. In my opinion, if you're doing reverse grip triceps, it's on the lower side of the triceps. I would say go a lot lower. It's like a forearm. So if I'm on the outside of my forearm, in my opinion, I can do only a little bit of weight compared to I can do a shit ton of weight on the inside. Of this, then I'm gonna probably hit 2 to 3 sets reverse, just because if I had reverse again, I'll hit the bottom part of my tricep. Again, my genetics, which is me personally, I have overworked biceps, so my triceps do not look as good. So one thing that I've always gone by is just work on your weaknesses. So if your weakness is deadlifting, work on your back and your leg. Same thing with benching. If your bench is weak, work on your chest. We already ran through straight triceps, and now we're just doing, I already did easy bar, preacher curl till failure. Now I'm going to do curling with dumbbells, preacher curl till failure. And then after We're gonna do sit down curls just to get the upper bicep to thicken. I already did regular curls, so now I'm just doing hammers. So now we're just starting off with one. So now we're just gonna end off with one. Let me start off. This is where it comes to the end of the fingertips. Elbow on the end, and it comes to the end of the fingertips like so. And just curl that with the forearm. You'll feel it tense up right here. And then later on we'll do the outside of the forearm. What happens with those? I'd say go pretty light on these for the simple fact. It's not the best way to move your wrist. I enjoy it. I see a lot of progression for myself, so I do it. It's up to you, but I suggest going lightweight if you do it. Take your dumbbell, put it sideways like this, and just rotate up and down. I'll get the sides of the forearm and grow girth. And that's the end of that one. You're gonna also throw in the middle of it. Grab a straight bar of your weight's choice. I'm gonna do 80 pound after I do 80 pound. It's pretty much the whole forearm workout. And you can either take it in front of you to work on the front of your forearms, put it in front of you, and kind of just up and down like this. And then if it's behind you, I'll show you. This is for the inside of the forearms. Grab where the line's at. And put your thumb where the rest of the fingers are too, so it targets your forearm. Put your hands as close as you can together. Up to the top. Let it roll out the fingertips to bottom, up. And just try to hold at the top so you get the most time on the tension. And you literally destroy those muscles. And then again, that'll be for the inside. This next one will be for the outside. Same thing, just grab it
very close
to you so you feel tension. Curl to the bottom fingertips, up, bottom fingertips, up. And just spin that